Throughout the few years I've been making videos, it's been very clear that my personal interest is to provide information and advice on all things fitness, how to lose weight, gain muscle, and so on, through the basis of scientific evidence. However, many of you have made it abundantly clear that you do not necessarily agree with all my conclusions. Sometimes it's because you don't agree with my personal interpretation of the literature, or that yourself have found scientific evidence stating otherwise. But by far the most common issue is that you might not believe the research because it does not align with your own personal experiences. And with that, I want to say is that the science can be, in a way, wrong. And that's okay. Now, I'm not saying science is wrong in terms of intentionally providing misinformation or deceitfully tweaking certain results. However, there are certainly questionable cases where study authors or funders have a clear financial interest that benefit from manipulating results for a certain product. But that's a topic for another day. As far as independent, peer-reviewed research, we can often rely on these findings to come from an objective standpoint. But that doesn't mean that we can rely on the findings to be applied universally. That is, if your own experiences have gotten you great results but is not in agreement with scientific literature, then don't change your approach just to fit the science. As much as I like to harp on the science, even my own experiences aren't rooted entirely on research. That's because most research do not claim to actually apply to everyone. Rather, there's often a range of outcomes within the science, and conclusions are simply looking at averages. Take, for example, one of the latest low-carb versus low-fat studies. In their findings, researchers concluded that after 1 year of assigning subjects to either a low-carb diet or a low-fat diet, both groups lost similar amounts of weight. Thus, we can normally conclude that both diets can be effective for weight loss. But taking a closer look at an individual level, we'll get a much more telling story. These graphs here, courtesy of the fine folks at examine.com, details the weight change of every single subject within the 12-month study. As you can see, there were extremely varying results in both groups. Some lost significant amounts of weight with low-carb or low-fat diets, but some, to the contrary, actually gained significant weight. So can we actually say unequivocally that both diets are just as effective for you? Clearly, no, we can't determine exactly where you fall within this range of subjects. Now consider this for everything else in fitness research. Should you rest 3 minutes between your sets just because a study says so, even though you've gotten stronger with just a minute of rest? Should you eat less protein just because one study said that you only need so-and-so number of grams per day to maximize muscle growth, even though you've tried that before and it didn't work out? These are the type of questions you need to ask yourself. Now, I don't want you to lose sight of the fact that, even though the science doesn't apply to you universally, it's still extremely valuable information thanks to its controlled testing with mostly objective outcomes. You're more likely to align with more parts of the science than you are to differ from it. At the very least, it gives us a place to start drawing up a fitness plan, where we then adjust based on our experiences. That being said, I want to emphasize one last relevant point. Just because something specifically works for you, it doesn't mean that it will work for everyone. And yes, this is a response to all the fine folks in the comments and elsewhere trying to tell others what to do just because something personally worked for them. If the science itself can't cover everyone, then how can one person's anecdote possibly be any better? To close, again, it's okay if the science doesn't always work out for you. It was never really intended to. It doesn't mean the science is lying to you, nor does it mean your experiences didn't count. Both can exist at the same time just fine. I hope you can all join me in giving a big thank you to all the amazing researchers and scientists for all the hard work they've done, both in the fitness realm and everywhere else, even if we can't apply their results to ourselves all the time. Please let me know what you think about the science and fitness and your experiences with it. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your science-loving friends. As always, thank you for watching and get your protein.